co-host, are you ready?
Am I? Yes, sir, I'm ready. All right, y'all, we will now begin our event. First and foremost, I would like to say good morning to everyone and welcome to the 2022 Martin Luther King Jr. Day of Service virtual celebration. Now, before we begin our presentation, we would like our virtual audience to know that this event is being recorded, and we also ask that you go under view options and select side-by-side gallery. And remember that this is the day of celebration and uplifting, so please stay positive in the chat.
Bienvenidos a todos a la celebración virtual del Día de Servicio de Martin Luther King Jr. de 2022. Antes de comenzar nuestra presentación, nos gustaría que todos vayan a sus opciones de visita y seleccionen una al lado de la otra galería. Y nos gustaría que todos sepan que este evento va a ser grabado. Recuerden que este día es de celebrar y elevar. Con eso pedimos que se mantenga positivo en el chat. Ahora, para empezar nuestra celebración de hoy, to start off today's celebration, es mi placer a presentarles. It's my pleasure to introduce Evelyn Chicas.
Good morning. My name is Evelyn Chicas, and I am an AmeriCorps member. I attend High Point High School, and today I would love to introduce my Ameri brother, Paul Ike, who will be singing Lift Every Voice and Sing.
Thank you so much, Evelyn, for that introduction. My name is Paul Ike, again, and I am a 12th grader from High Point High School, and I will be singing Lift Every Voice and Sing.
What an amazing way to start off our celebration today. Paul, we got to give it up for those vocals, man. That was really, really good. Thank you, Paul, por esa maravillosa canción. Buenos días a todos. Mi nombre es Daniela Pastor Reyes y me da mucha alegría estar aquí con ustedes y a tener a mi compañero Ronald Duez a mi lado para la celebración.
Thanks, Daniela. We are so excited to be here with you all to celebrate the life of Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. and his contribution not only to minorities, but to America as a whole. Today, we've got a lot in store for you. There'll be performances, workshops, and guest speakers. Today, we see January 17th as a day on instead of a day off. Let's all reflect on a quote from Dr. King. Life's most persistent and urgent question is, what are you doing for others?
Hoy no solo queremos ver este día como un día de descanso, sino como una frase que MLK dijo una vez. La pregunta más persistente y urgente de la vida es, ¿qué estamos haciendo por los demás? Y en este día habrá presentaciones, talleres, invitados especiales para la celebración. Estoy muy agradecida de estar reunida con todos ustedes una vez más. Hasta me pongo a pensar de todo lo que se ha podido lograr este último año. Y a recordar de todos los cambios que hemos pasado. Es increíble que tan rápido pasa el tiempo, pero aquí estamos haciendo nuestra propia historia, igual como lo hizo Martin Luther King Jr., quien estamos recordando hoy.
I completely agree with you, Daniela. I can't believe we're already in 2022. I remember last year around this time, we began with a rocky start. We just finished our first year in a pandemic and elected a new president, and unfortunately, that led to a lot of uproar. But out of everything that's happened, we've learned to adapt and overcome any obstacles the world has thrown at us. That's exactly what Martin Luther King Jr. did. That's called resilience in adversity.
En eso tienes razón. Ahora tenemos a un nuevo presidente. También hemos sobrevivido otro año estando en una pandemia. Martin Luther King fue una esperanza en el tiempo de adversidad, de dificultad, de alegrías y tristezas. Y por eso, siempre hay que creer que hay una luz al final del tunnel.
Dr. King once said, peace is not merely a distant goal that we seek, but a means by which we arrive at that goal. Dr. King intended these words as a comment on war, but when I hear them, I think of more day-to-day concerns and of the way in which we want to live our lives become separated from how we actually live moment by moment. We may want peace in our lives, but the only way to achieve peace is to be peaceful yourself.
Martin Luther King dijo una vez, la paz no es simplemente una meta lejana que buscamos, sino un medio por la que llegamos a esa meta. MLK pretendía que estas palabras fueron un comentario sobre la guerra, pero cuando las escucho, pienso en preocupaciones diarias y en el modo que queremos vivir nuestras vidas se separa de la forma en que realmente vivimos, momento a momento. Puede que queramos paz en nuestras vidas, pero la única manera de lograr la paz es estar en paz con uno mismo. Igual en esa manera vamos a llegar a nuestro objeto del día de hoy, que es honrar a MLK. Y empezamos con nuestras presentaciones.
Así es. Our goal is to honor and celebrate the dream that Dr. King had of a united community. Y ahora, to kick off our MLK Day of Service, we have a fantastic skit put together by our AmeriCorps members.
All right, you all, I appreciate your patience. It looks like we're having some technical difficulties, but not to worry. Parece que estamos teniendo unas dificultades técnicas, pero no se preocupen, se queden pacientes con nosotros y vamos a seguir con nuestra presentación. In the meantime, can I know everyone's favorite MLK quote?
A lot of I have a dreams.
I have a dream. I know we just mentioned an amazing quote. Peace is not merely a distant goal that we seek, but a means by which we arrive at that goal. How do you guys feel about this? Do you guys agree that it's not about the distance, but how we achieve this goal? I see a lot of agrees. So do I. It all starts with yourself, you guys. It all starts with yourself.
Ooh, Precious said in the chat, or at least her favorite quote from MLK. I have a dream that my children will not be judged by the color of your skin, but by the content of the character. That's probably the most important thing here, you know?
That's amazing.
We have our skit back.
Please enjoy, everyone.
Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to Family Feud. I'm your host, not Ronald Lewis, but the great and mighty Martin Luther King Jr. And today we have two special teams who are not only here to celebrate me, but to battle to win Family Feud. Please help me welcome the Civilizers.
Hello, 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 y'all. My name is Apul Kai, and I am an AmeriCorps member with LAYC, Maryland Multicultural Youth Center. And just think of me as part of the next generation of changemakers.
Buenos días, yo soy Sonia Sotomayor, juez de la Corte Suprema de los Estados Unidos. I am Sonia Sotomayor, and I am Justice of the Supreme Court of the United States.
Good morning, buenos días a todos. I'm Ellen Choa, a Hispanic American engineer and former astronaut.
Nice to meet you all. Now please give a warm welcome to the Rebels.
Good afternoon, everyone. I mean, good morning. Getting my days mixed up. I didn't know I needed an introduction, but I'm Malcolm X.
Well, hello, everyone. Very happy to be here this fine morning. I am the civil rights fighter, Rosa Parks.
Hello, hello, everyone. I'm Lucy Stone. I'm an anti-slavery and women's rights activist.
All right. Thank you for our wonderful teams for being here today. Now, before we start, here are the rules. The player with the highest scoring answer from each team will choose if their team plays or passes. Now that we're all on the same page, let's get started. Can Mr. Apul Kai and Malcolm X please answer the first question? Are you gentlemen ready?
Yes, sir.
All right. The first question is, what is a well-known quote from yours truly, MLK?
I got this one. I'm actually surprised that Mr. X did not buzz before I did. But I believe you said, I have a dream, or actually you had a dream.
I did have a dream. It was a good one. All right, let us see if that is on the board. And it is. It is also our number one answer. What a surprise.
Is it really a surprise now?
I suppose not, my brother. Would your team like to play or pass?
We would like to continue in this game of the feud of families.
All right, you'd like to play. Mm-hmm. Now on to Miss Sonia Sotomayor. How are you doing today?
Doing very good. How are you? ¿Cómo estás?
Yo soy bien. Mi hermana. Now, before I ask you this next question, I heard that you were the first, yes, the first Hispanic woman to be nominated as Justice of the Supreme Court of the United States. How's that been for you?
Very good, darling. Let me tell you, Dr. King. I grew up in the Bronx in New York to Puerto Rican parents who had barely any education. So I worked hard and I received my bachelor's at Princeton and then went to Yale. And let me translate for my Spanish speakers out there. Yo nací en Puerto Rico, Puerto Rico. Mis padres nacieron en Puerto Rico. Yo nací en the Bronx, en Nueva York. Yo trabajé muy duro para lograr mi educación. Yo fui a Princeton y después a la Facultad de Derecho de Yale. Thank you.
That's great. Princeton and Yale, I think they're called Ivy League schools. Very interesting. All right. Once again, the question is, what is a well-known quote from yours truly, MLK?
Okay. My favorite quote, actually, from you has to be, you can kill the dreamer, but you cannot kill the dream.
Oh, that's actually one of my favorites. It's my favorite, or at least one of them, because I made it. Survey says that it is up there. Congratulations. Woo! All right, Miss Elvin Ochoa, how are you doing this fine morning?
I'm doing great this fine morning. Though I wanted to ask, have you ever read about the first cow astronaut? I just read about it, and it landed on the moon. All right, you get it? Funny, right?
That's quite the funny joke, I guess. Now, before I ask you this question, I have to ask, how does it feel to be the first Hispanic woman to go to space?
Well, I'm definitely very proud of my accomplishments. Spending 41 days in space is not easy, let me tell you.
I'm sure it's not. But now I have an astronaut joke for you. What is an astronaut's favorite day?
I'm not sure.
It's Monday. you see what I'm doing?
Yes, yes, I see it.
Man, the production team hitting on me some awes. But with that said, the question is, what is a well-known quote from MLK?
Well, I have to go with, do one thing that scares you every day.
Oh. Now, how can you confuse me with a white woman? Okay, I'm not judging or anything, but I'm just saying, I am not. Now, it's still a very great quote, but it's not from me. It's from Eleanor Roosevelt, who was the wife of our 32nd president, Franklin Roosevelt. Now let's bring it back, or should I say, bring it black, to Brother Paul.
Bring it black. That was a good one. Now that was a good one. But I believe that was our first wrong answer, correct?
Yes, brother, you certainly are.
All right, we still got this.
All right, now your next answer will determine whether you win this round or continue. The question is, what is a quote from?
No need for the question. I remember when you said this one. So I believe it's injustice anywhere is a threat. Yeah, I remember. It's a threat to justice everywhere. Something like that.
All right, sir. I'm going to tell you my own quote. Anyways, survey says it is up there. Congratulations to the Civil Logics team for winning the first round and putting 270 points on the board. Now, for the Rebels, that does not mean that you are out for the count. You can still make a comeback in the next round. With that said, let's move on to round two. Can I have Ms. Sonia Sotomayor and Ms. Rosa Parks answer the question, please? Are you ladies ready?
Yes, sir.
All right. Now, the question is, besides MLK, who are some other minority leaders or figures?
I would like to go. I'm going to go with Harriet Tubman, the bravest woman I've ever learned about, who went through a lot to rescue slaves through the Underground Railroad.
All right, survey says that she is up there, but she is our fourth answer on the board.
That's okay.
Now for Ms. Parks, what is your answer?
Nice try, Ms. Sonya, nice try. I'm gonna go with that great, great man himself, Malcolm X.
Preach, great sister. Answer. What is it on the board? It seems like he is on the board today. He is also the number one answer. What a surprise.
Yeah. You almost forgot about that part. It's not surprising.
Brother Malcolm. It's not. Would your team like to play or pass?
All right, team. Should we play?
We would definitely like to play.
Okay, we're gonna play.
Sounds good. Let's continue. Miss Lucy Stone, how are you doing?
I'm doing good. Happy to be here.
Sounds good. Now, I heard you're one of the first women to earn a college degree. Can you talk a bit about that?
Yes, I actually had to work as a teacher to earn money so I could be able to attend college. It wasn't easy, but once I got in, I chose public lecturing as my career. I dedicated my life to fighting for anti-slavery and women's rights, two things that are very important to me and everyone should know more about.
That sounds very interesting. You know, I'm sure that was an inspiration to many women and proved that all it takes is a little bit of effort and perseverance to achieve anything. Now, the question is, other than, you know, me, MLK, who is another minority leader or figure?
Okay, I'm going to have to go with Cesar Chavez, the famous Mexican-American labor and civil rights activist.
Good choice. Survey says that he is up there. Great job. Now, on to Mr. Malcolm X. How are you, my brother from another mother?
Doing great, brother. I'm living in these trying times.
That's the truth. But I have to ask, is your last name really X?
Well, if you didn't know, I was in jail. And while I was, I read many books on the nation and religion of Islam. This inspired me to change my name from Little to X. This also inspired my view on our civil rights. And this is why I chose, I almost said a word I shouldn't have said, but to voice my opinions through actions and not words, unlike the person in front of me.
You know what, brother? If you're talking about me, you done painted a big red Malcolm X on your back, okay?
Where are your glasses at?
All right, that's what I thought.
My brother's on your face. They are on your face. Not mine, not yours.
You know what, since Malcolm X, here, take that X, Malcolm X.
I don't know why an X appeared.
My brothers, we love one another. We fight the oppressors, not each other.
I don't know if I love Brother Malcolm right now.
I think Rosa Parks has a point. The oppressors, not each other. Okay? Back to the game. The question is, other than Malcolm X, who is another minority leader?
I'll go with my girl, Sojourner Truth. The first African-American woman to win a court case against our oppressors.
Let's see. Survey says that she is up there. All right. Back to Miss Parks.
I knew that.
Hello, sir.
Hello, hello. Your team has one strike. Yes, I said one strike. Two more, and the civilizer team can steal. Are you ready?
Boy, am I a black woman from Alabama in the 50s? Yeah, you know we're ready.
All right. Now, if you don't mind me asking, can you talk more about that bus incident?
Well, I want to be happier to inform you that I, in fact, did not give my seat to that man due to me being tired. And I wasn't old either, as I was the young age of 42. But, you know, actually, I was tired. I was very tired of the racism and oppression around me. Ain't that right, brothers Malcolm and King?
Yes, ma'am.
Indeed, sister.
You know, I completely agree with you. I'd be tired too. I'm actually a little tired right now. I'm getting old. Now, your question is, other than Malcolm, sorry, thinking about Malcolm, other than MLK, who is another minority leader?
Well, let me tell you, I know who my leader is. Barack Obama. Now, that is a fine piece of chocolate right there, I tell you.
Miss Parks, let me remind you, sister, that this is a family show. All right, we got some youngins back at home.
I'm sorry. It is okay.
It is okay. Let's see if he's on the board, though. and he is not. Oh man, brother Obama, not on the board. Now, although the first African-American president and 45th president, Barack Obama, was a great leader, unfortunately, he is not up there.
How dare they not have my Barack up there? How dare they?
I don't make the rules, sister. I just follow them.
This is crazy.
Now, on to Miss Lucy Stone. Your team has two strikes.
One strike.
Your answer, it's two. You got one in your name as well. Don't forget that. Now, you have two strikes. If your answer is not on the board, the civilizers can steal, and you lose this round. Are you ready?
Yes, I am ready.
All right. The question is, other than MLK, who is another minority leader or figure?
Okay. The last and winning answer for my team is going to be our opponent, Sonia Sotomayor.
All right. Remember now, this answer determines if your team wins this round or if the other team gets a chance to steal. Survey says...
it's wrong.
That she is up there. Congratulations to the rebel team for putting 400 points on the board and getting in the lead.
You're like, you should stick. Now, stand at the Supreme Court.
Before we start getting into any arguments, we're going to give it up for the Rebels one more time. And unfortunately, due to our amount of funding or lack thereof, we only have enough time to finish half this episode of Family Feud. Hope you all enjoyed, and we'll probably see you next time.
I will get you back, Malcolm.
I don't know about you guys, but that got a couple of laughs out of me. Un fuerte aplauso para nuestro equipo de AmeriCorps por su presentación. A continuación, we would now love to welcome, ahora nos encantaría dar la bienvenida a nuestra, our LAYC President and CEO, Ms. Lupi Quinteros Grady.
Let me just get my video camera ready. Something was going on with my video as well. There you go. Hello, everyone. It is so good to be here with you all. What a great morning so far. I want to definitely thank everyone for joining us today in celebration of Dr. Martin Luther King. As we get going, and you've already been listening to the games and the AmeriCorps, thank you so much for putting so much of this program together. I know you've had support of the staff, but it's so great to see you at the forefront and you showing your leadership as well. Thank you. And I want you to, I know that it was already asked of you, but as we're looking and reflecting and celebrating Dr. King's legacy, I want you to put in the chat one word that describes for you Dr. King's legacy. Just one word. Think about what you know about Dr. King and think about what he means to you personally. Or what have you heard he's done or accomplished? And just put it down there. So I'm just giving you guys some time to do that. So today, this is an annual celebration, and someone mentioned it, it's a day on, not a day off. It is really important for me to put in context why that is the case. So you all have heard of the Emancipation Proclamation, right? That was done 100 years before Dr. King gave his, you know, famous speech, I Have a Dream. That proclamation was the Emancipation Proclamation that was signed by President Abraham Lincoln that we all are aware of. That was supposed to free slaves. So that was a huge win. But even after that, 100 years later, Dr. King not, he wasn't by himself, but I still had this vision and had the courage to fight on and to see and recognize the injustices that were still taking place 100 years later after signing that Emancipation Proclamation. So I want you guys to have that sink in. This is 100 years later after Emancipation Proclamation that Dr. King in August 28, 1963 gives this speech. And it was a speech that was very powerful, as we all know about it. This is the only holiday that celebrates someone that is not a president, right? That is Dr. King. So it is about the legacy, but also for us to really reflect and put in context what was taking place during this time. It was asked of many of you, what is your favorite quote? And, you know, some of you, not sure if you all know, it was stated here earlier that he was very, had written his speech, but it was Mahalia Jackson, as he was saying his speech, that I believe he went off script some, because at that time, she whispered, or she kind of mentions to him, tell him your dream, Martin, tell him your dream. And so he has to, at that point, really speak from, I guess there was a vision that he had had. And that's when you hear him talk about, I have a dream. So she goes, tell him your dream, tell him your dream. And then he goes into that and just really at that point talks about something. I want you guys to listen to a couple of things that stood out to me in that speech. Before he goes, sorry, I have a dog and it's, you know, he mentions, let us not wallow in the valley of despair. I say to you, my friends, we have difficulties of today and tomorrow. So this sounds very familiar even today. So we're talking about 100 days of the Emancipation Proclamation that late, 100 years later that he gives this speech. And here we are 60 something years later and look at where we're at. So there's been much accomplished, but his speech talks about racial injustice. He talks about what's democracy. He mentions we all are created equal. He talks about dignity and being treated in such a way where at that time, our young people, our youth of color, all they would see is signs that say white only. He talks about inclusion, right? We now have this terminology when we mention about not being seen. This is what he's talking about and a lot much more. He talks about not being satisfied with what's taking place at the time. I ask of you as you reflect that some of these things really resonate with you all now. Not being satisfied with what we see. Are we looking at what is democracy? We're talking about rights that have been fought for, that are still needing to be fought for, voting rights, that you all, as our young people, and the next leaders, the next generation of leaders, are so critical to this country. So today, you know, I always look forward to this day as so many of all of us are thinking about this, or many of us aren't quite understanding the depth of just what was done at this time. So I'm grateful for Dr. King's legacy. I'm grateful for all of those that had the courage to fight for the rights, for doing what is right, for standing up, for just not going along. And mind you, this was a huge, this was over 200,000 people that came together and believed there were Black, he invited whites, a fifth of the population that attended was white. This was to make a statement. And so here we find ourselves, and I know this has been a challenging last 2 years, And we've seen it even more with our communities of color. So as I put in context, many of you are familiar with the Latin American Youth Center. Here we are, or many of you know LAYC, Maryland Multicultural Youth Census Center. And we are here and we exist because we believe you, our young people, are important and need to be invest. We need to invest in you. So we are here, and I hope that many of you are in our programs, or if not, that you all reach out, because we want to create those spaces where you can be great, where you can grow and learn and come to yourself, as we need leaders. We need leaders, yes, you. And I ask of you to dream big, to dream and to not stop, regardless how challenging these times have been. We need you to continue to understand how important you are, but also just how we are here for you, and that you are not alone, and that we do see you, and that together we build our community. We don't have to wait for anybody else to do it. We can come together and understand that whatever small contributions we make, they make a difference, each one of us. So in honor of Dr. King's legacy, I ask, what are your contributions? No matter how small, big, whether it's being kind in your community, whether it's being kind to your sibling, whatever it is, in honor of Dr. King, think about in the spirit of what he did, but also just think about, like, in context of what's going on, how significant this work has been and continues to be to fight for, you know, for the racial injustices we continue to say, to not be satisfied. And so I am grateful. I thank the staff, Allison Moore, our director of Prince George's County, our AmeriCorps members, all of the staff that have come together to just put this together for you all. And I really hope that you're encouraged, that you stay engaged for the rest of the presentation. And I know they have a wonderful keynote speaker coming on right after me. Thank you everyone that's here and that made this a priority this morning. Thank you and enjoy the rest of the day.
I'm so sorry, I was muted. Can we give it up one more time for our wonderful CEO, Ms. Lupi Quinteros Grady, and thank you so much for being here today, Ms. Lupi. We are so proud that for over a decade, the LAYC MMYC has proudly hosted our MLK Junior Day of Celebration. It's a day of reflection and encouragement. Today, we've invited some special guests to give you some words of wisdom. To kick us off, a quote from the City of Hyattsville Administrator, Tracy Douglas. We're excited to partner with the Latin American Youth Center, LAYC, on this 2022 Martin Luther King Jr. Day of Service. LAYC has an impressive record of providing service and unwavering support to youth and those in need. These past 2 years have magnified the importance of organizations like LAYC MMYC and the critical need to serve those who have been impacted by the deadly COVID-19 pandemic. Today, as we reflect on Dr. King's life, legacy, and his commitment to serving others, we are particularly grateful to serve. Thank you, LAYC MMYC, for all you do. Now, I would like to introduce our NJROTC cadet from Northwestern High School, Kimberly Melgar.
Hello, everyone. My name is Cadet Kimberly Melgar. I am a next-gen student from LAYC MLK, and I'm a part of Northwestern High School's Navy JROTC program. I'm a first-year cadet as a sophomore, and JROTC has taught me many skills in just 1 year. I have learned how to become a more efficient leader, learn more about our nation, and college prep. This program is a great opportunity for students to enhance their leadership skills and become a better version of themselves. With much honor and pleasure, I'm proud to announce our mayor of Hyattsville, Kevin Ward. Kevin Ward is a husband, father, dog dad, and technologist who values dedication, service, and excellence. As nearly two-decade resident of the DC metro area, Kevin expresses his love for the area and all it has to offer. Kevin was raised by his mother, who held him to consistent high standards and taught him that hard work is the only work. Because of how he was raised, Kevin brings a unique perspective to the challenges of serving in multiple government. Kevin learned the value of dedication at an early age, growing up with a single mother who worked hard to provide as much as possible for him. Kevin's hard work, dedication, and determination to avoid a life of poverty and mediocrity inspired him to do all he could to excel academically and find his passion. Even though he had severe dyslexia, Kevin never let it become an excuse not to give it his all. After earning a bachelor's degree from Texas A&M University, Kevin went on to work in consulting and furthered his education in both Columbia University and MIT. Currently, Kevin is working in technology, working with educational institutions, financial institutions, and other large organizations to design, implement, and deliver complex technological solutions. Kevin often says, "I'm built for service." He always says, he always wanted to give his time to, as he says, meet people where they are and make an impact on someone's life, not just an impression. May you please join me to welcome our keynote speaker, Mayor Kevin Ward.
Good morning, and thank you all for joining this special Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. Day of Service in partnership with Latin American Youth Center. My name is Kevin Ward. I'm a husband, father, dog dad, a techie, a sneakerhead, and most proud to say that I'm the mayor of the city of Hyattsville. I would be remiss if I didn't say I really wish we could be in person today and we could see one another's faces and participate with one another live, but we know what we've been going through over the past almost 2 years, and I hope that you all are staying safe and warm as we endure yet another winter in the middle of a pandemic. Before we get started, though, I must give deep thanks to the City of Hyattsville and LAYC staff for putting together a great program for this day of service. There will be presentations, awards, and many other different things, and you all will have a great time. So I thank them, but I also thank you, all of you dedicated participants, for taking time out of your day to listen to what I believe will be a powerful program. I hope everyone coming into this is here to learn about Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. and his legacy. Some of us know him as a seminal civil rights figure. Others of us know him as a Nobel Peace Prize winner. And many of us may know him simply as the man who once stated, "I have a dream." But there are some of us who may know very little about Dr. King and his legacy. And today is designed to teach us more. But I must say this before I go any further. Dr. King's dream is a piece of each one of us. We are the personification of that dream. We want to be judged by the content of our character, not by the color of our skin. Most of all, to me, Dr. King was a servant to his people. He made a choice to stand up for change and be a voice for a community that simply was not allowed to speak up. There was little blueprint for the work he was doing, and he was under constant threat and pressure from all sides, but he never stopped doing what he knew to be right in service of the greater good. And that's what we must do what we know is great and what we know is for the greater good and in service of the greater community. Today, I hope we can reflect on the incredible impact of that service that Dr. King personified. He changed the world in an immeasurable way, and by doing so, he continues to serve as an inspiration to us all. He's an inspiration to me. Many of the things that he talked about and did are the reason I became a community leader. They're the reason I participate in public service, and they're the reason that I wanted to be on city council and ultimately now the mayor of the city of Hyattsville. Without his actions, there would be no Kevin Ward, mayor, city of Hyattsville, because he taught us that we should be judged by the content of our character, not the color of our skin. Let me tell you a little bit of how I got here. Like many of you, I grew up on the margins, feeling forgotten and not thought about. I grew up in a single parent home where my mother worked two, sometimes three jobs just to get by, trying to make ends that seemed so incredibly far apart, trying to make them meet, and they couldn't always meet. I had to go to school. I had to come home. I had to do chores. I had to go to work. I had to help pay bills, something that I believe many of you may relate to. But one thing I knew was that I could be great. And I want to tell each one of you that you can be great. Work is hard. Work is not easy. And we must continue to pull our own weight for ourselves so that we stand beside Dr. King's legacy and are judged by who we are, not by how we look. We must do the work. For me, in many ways, that work was challenging. I am severely dyslexic, so reading does not come easy to me. You've already heard me stumble a couple of times in just reading my speech. But what looks like normal words to some people looks like a jumbled mess to me. And I have to, in the moment, make something clear of it. So for me, it was the exemplification of what Dr. King said, that remember me because of my works, not because of my awards. Remember me because of what I did and how I made someone feel, not because of all the letters I have behind my name, because of accomplishments academically. But each and every one of you knows that service in our community is the highest level of service. And from a very young age, I was taught that. Even when we didn't have a lot, my mother still told me to go out and help others. Help them take out their trash, help them cut their lawn, help them hang pictures, help them move furniture. All these things still ring in my head as she said, "You are great. Don't let where you are from determine where you can go." And many times we may think that because we live in a certain zip code or on a certain street, that we can't make it through. I grew up in a very difficult situation, but I made it to where I made it because every day my mother and myself, I myself, reminded myself that difficult work doesn't mean you can't be great. Difficult times don't mean you cannot be great. What makes you great is who you are and how you focus and how you move forward. Nothing comes easy. But we cannot lose who we are in those moments. So to each and every one of you, I say, understand your foundation. Understand who you are and understand that when you do the hard work, and we all know what hard work is. We know the difference between doing something easy and doing something the easy way and doing something the hard way and getting it done. So through all of that, I tell you all this one thing. I want to make sure you understand this. That you are great. And I'll take it even a step further and say that the you that you are is better than the you anybody wants you to be. What that means is what your friends want you to be, sometimes what your parents want you to be, what your family and what your community want you to be, may not be in the same vein of who you know you are. At the end of the day, when you are who you are, you can soar to great heights and you can do all the things you need to do. So please remember that the you that you are is better than the you anybody wants you to be. So as I grew up and I got through high school and I figured out what I wanted to do and where I wanted to go to college, I went to the great university called Texas A&M in College Station, Texas. And I studied business and computer science. And I knew that at the end of that time, I wanted to do great things. I worked in consulting, then I moved over to technology. And then I realized that because of some programs I'd been involved in, that it was time for me to get involved in the community. I remained very active in my community. And then when I moved to DC almost 25 years ago now, I decided that I was going to continue to be a part of the community and do the things that I needed to do. With that, we landed in Hyattsville. I got on the city council and eventually became the mayor. This road wasn't easy. Being a public official is not easy. You have to work with others. You have to listen. You have to hear things you don't want to hear. You have to hear things said to you that you don't necessarily think are fair, but you have to be measured and understand that when people are in need and when people need service, they need leaders who are there to serve. So with all of that, I want us to take a moment today and make a commitment to keep Dr. King's legacy alive in all of us. You don't have to change the world today, but you should know in your hearts that you can, because you have that ability. And I would be remiss to not point out the power of the partnerships here. The city of Hyattsville is hosting this event in partnership with the Latin American Youth Center because together our message reaches a greater and more diverse community than if either one of us were to work alone. There are many times we think that we can just get it done, but when we partner with somebody else and we put our heads together and our strengths together and our thoughts together, we can do great things. So never think that you have to go at it alone. So I want to leave you with this challenge. On this day of service, find one small way you can be a servant for good, whether it's in your school, your work, your friendships, your family, or your neighborhood. Find one little way that you can be a servant for good. Maybe it's saying that every time you see someone who needs help, with groceries, with opening the door, with putting away things, that you're going to step up and do it. Maybe it's saying that I am going to take some of this stuff off of my parents' plate and I'm going to help my brothers and sisters with their homework. I'm going to clean the house before I'm asked to do it. Think about those small things that you can be a servant for good that impacts your community and moves it forward in a positive way. Today, it might just be picking up that cup of coffee that's next to the trash in the park. But let's do those small acts. Inspire yourself to build greater actions and a greater and closer community. Find yourself and understand who your partners can be and dream big. Even when it gets hard, and trust me, it will get hard. Some of you know it's already hard. Know that you have the power to make a difference. Stand up for change and use the voice that Dr. King gave you. Be the personification of that dream. Be judged by the content of your character and not the color of your skin. Thank you. I appreciate your time. I am really happy to have been here, and I look forward to speaking to you all a little bit later.
Thank you, Mayor Ward, for those words. Like you said, you're going to be with us in person today, but it's always an honor having you with us. Now, we would like to take a moment to give special thanks to members of the LAYC MMYC family who have gone above and beyond for their communities. These individuals stepped up in one of the most difficult years, despite a global pandemic and tumultuous social moments. LAYC MMYC is proud to present our fourth annual Community Champion Awards. The Community Champion Awards are given to local community members who humbly, selflessly, and proudly give back and advocate on behalf of our youth and their families. the recipients of this year's award, embody Dr. King's vision of service by living their lives answering Dr. King's most persistent and urgent question: what are you doing for others?
Mandamos muchas gracias a la alcaldesa que no pudo estar aquí presente con nosotros, pero está con nosotros en espíritu. Ahora nos gustaría tomar un momento para agradecer especialmente a los miembros de la familia LAYC MMYC que han hecho todo lo posible por sus comunidades. Estas personas dieron un paso adelante en uno de los años más difíciles a pesar de una pandemia mundial y momentos sociales intensos. LAYC MMYC se orgullece de presentar nuestra cuarta edición anual de los premios Community Champion Awards. Los premios Community Champions se entregan a los miembros de la comunidad local quien demuestran humildad y orgullo en defendiendo a nuestros jóvenes y sus familias. Los ganadores del premio de este año se encargarán de la visión de servicio de Martin Luther King, a responder, a dedicar sus vidas respondiendo a la pregunta más persistente y urgente de Dr. King, ¿qué estás haciendo por los demás?
Y ahora, Ms. Jackie Lozama will introduce our first award winner.
Hello, everyone. My name is Jackie Lozama, and I'm the Housing Programs Manager for MMYC. And it is with great pleasure that I give the award to Dejanay Day for the Youth Community Champion Award. Ms. Day is a graduate of the University of Maryland Eastern Shore class of 2018 and has been the co-chair for the Prince George's County Youth Action Board since 2019. The Youth Action Board is a group of young adults with lived experience that serve as experts providing insight on the needs of youth that are experiencing homelessness throughout Prince George's County. Ms. Day is passionate in advocating for youth homelessness as she has experienced homelessness during her college career. She understands the struggle of her fellow peers to strive and thrive through obstacles in the community. Again, it is with great pleasure that we give Dejanay Day, the Youth Action Co-Chair of the Youth Action Board, the Youth Community Champion Award. Dejanay, if you'd like, you can say a few words.
Thank you, Ms. Jackie, and thank you everybody for congratulating me in the chat. I'm just speechless. I'm just really happy I got this award in that me and my fellow Youth Action Board members are being represented on this platform. And I'm hoping anybody that is on this platform today that is interested in joining the Youth Action Board to advocate for any youth homelessness and anything that follows around it, you can. I just want to let everybody know on a call that you have a voice and that you are being heard. But thank you, everybody, for your support. And thank you all for everything that you do.
Thank you, Dejanay, for those words. Up next, we have Troy Eccles introducing our next recipient.
Good morning, everyone. For those that do not know me, my name is Troy Eccles, and I serve as the Re-Engagement Program Manager here at the Maryland Multicultural Youth Center in Prince George's County. Today, it's my honor to introduce Robert Bell. To provide you guys with a little bit of background on just how brilliant he is, Mr. Bell attended the Morgan State University, where he received two bachelor's degrees in criminal justice and psychology. He then went on to receive his master's of social work at the University of Maryland. And as of now, in Mr. Bell's educational journey, he's a PhD candidate at Arizona State University. I will also add for those that know the weight that this carries in the public service community that Mr. Bell is a proud member of Omega Psi Phi Fraternity Incorporated. Mr. Bell currently serves as a program director for the Promise Place Drop-In Center, the first and the only youth drop-in center in the entire county, I might add. Before accepting this role at the drop-in center, Mr. Bell served as the director for the Promise Place Homeless Shelter. It's an understatement, I'll say, to say that Mr. Bell is a pillar in this community because he is so much more than just that. He has helped change the lives of many youth, helping them overcome obstacles that they've been presented with and dealing them a new set of cards that has transformed them into college graduates, U.S. military service members, local law enforcement, and much more. It is because of his important work with our youth in this community that we want to present him with the Youth Community Champion Award. Thank you for all that you do, Mr. Bell. And unfortunately, I don't believe that Mr. Bell was able to be here with us. However, he does have someone here to accept the award on his behalf. If you are, if you have access to say anything and you want to say anything on his behalf, you can have the floor now.
Unfortunately, the person who is or who would be accepting Mr. Bell's award is not here today. But I just want to say again, thank you, Mr. Bell, in spirit, for all the work you do is very important to our community, and congratulations on your award. Now, Ms. Diana Edwards is introducing our next award.
Good morning, everyone. My name is Diana Edwards, and I am the Workforce Development Program Manager at the LAYC MMYC Prince George's County site. Today, I am honored to be introducing our next Community Champion recipient, Ms. Marnie Kenefic. Marnie is an advocate for service learning and school-to-work pathways. She's inspired by the AmeriCorps program staff that she supports across our state. Before joining the Governor's Office on Service and Volunteerism as a trainer in 2019, her career journey included HR consulting and creating learning communities. She has a master's degree from the Harvard Graduate School of Education. Marnie shares that she's grateful for her big family's love in the adventure of raising no one but two teenagers during a pandemic. Please help me welcome to our virtual stage, Ms. Marnie Kenefic.
Tahiana, thank you so much. I appreciate so much the chance to thank members of our LAYC family and community. As you mentioned, a lot of people have been serving behind the scenes in the pandemic, and that's really my view. I have the great honor of being able to see behind the scenes all of the beautiful work you're doing across the state. And I want to take this moment to shine a light on mental health, which has been strained for all of us during the pandemic, and yet we continue to serve and give to each other. And I want to share a quote from Martin Luther King about this. That, you know, a lot of people don't love themselves, and they go through life with deep and haunting emotional conflict. So the length of life means that you must love yourself. And you know that loving yourself also means you've got to accept yourself. So for those of you who are serving and you know and you receive praise or recognition for the service that you do, remember that you also must give love and acceptance to yourself, forgiveness to yourself, be gentle with yourself during this time. Thank you, everyone.
Gracias, Señora Kenefic. And before we move on to our next recipient, we are excited that Donnell Potts, the Chief Program Officer for Sasha Bruce, is actually here to accept on Rob Bell's behalf. Mr. Potts, would you like to say a few words?
Yes, thank you. Sorry, I was a little late arriving, but I definitely wanted to accept on the behalf of Rob Bell and the tireless work that Rob does at the Promise Place Shelter. Rob's heart for the young people that come through Promise Place is evident in the amount of work and the amount of hours and dedication that he puts in to ensure the safety and well-being of the youth that come through Promise Place. So I'm proud and I'm happy that he asked me to step in his place. I feel honored to do so. And thank you all for recognizing his great work in Prince George's County. Thank you.
Thank you once again. And now we would love to introduce our LAYC MMYC Managing Director, Ms. Allison Moore.
Good morning. My name is Allison Moore, and I am the Managing Director for the LAYC MMYC Prince George's County. It's my great honor and privilege to introduce our next award winner, Kelly Gordon. Kelly embodies service and exudes a passion for serving young people. She constantly goes above and beyond in her dedication to meeting young people where they're at. She's always the first to jump in and help, answering the sometimes literal call to service, day or night. Thank you, Kelly, for never declining my calls. Ms. Gordon received her Master's of Education with a focus on acquired brain injury from the George Washington University, and her Bachelor's of Science from University of South Carolina with a focus on psychology and nursing. She's an active member of the Delta Sigma Theta sorority. She currently is the program manager for the Prince George's County Department of Social Services Youth Homelessness Demonstration Project. Her success in cultivating and fostering relationships with key stakeholders, young adults experiencing homelessness, funders, and community partners was instrumental in the development of a coordinated community plan for Prince George's County that represents the best opportunity to end youth homelessness. Ms. Gordon also works closely with the Youth Action Board, a board made up of solely young people under the age of 25 and young adults with lived experience of homelessness, and so that they are treated as the experts and involved in the planning and decision-making. Prior to her current role, she managed several programs within the Department of Defense and Veterans Affairs, including supporting key projects around homelessness, including housing over 1,000 veterans in the LA area. Please join me in congratulating one of my own personal heroes, Ms. Kelly Gordon.
Thank you, Allison. This is great. Thank you, Allison, again. Thank you, LAYC leadership. This has just been an amazing experience joining you all today for this celebration. Good morning to all. This is truly an honor to be recognized for my service on Dr. Martin Luther King Jr.'s 93rd birthday holiday celebration. His commitment to equality, love, and justice for all permeates our nation and should be the qualities we all stand by and strive to accomplish. There is no cost in caring and sharing and treating others with respect. I've tried, and focused my life and practice around my passion for work and serving others. And my work to do so in here, particularly in the county, Prince George's County, I want to be the change that I want to see. And I challenge us all to be that person or to be those people or groups in service for others. Thank you, LAYC, for your endless work and service and the community changing lives for so many individuals, so many families, near and far. And, it's just a beautiful thing to see our groups constantly cultivating and supporting and, feeding into others. So thank you, thank you, thank you. Again, this is a special acknowledgement. I congratulate all of the award recipients. And kudos to the amazing youth teenagers who are leading the today's event. It's just great to see you all, promoting and serving and doing the work of the community. So thank you.
Thank you, Ms. Gordon. And once again, congratulations on today's award. You know, everyone, we've had an amazing start to our MLK celebration today. Pero eso no es todo. Now we would love to introduce our amazing LAYC youth and participants who have worked tremendously hard with their presentations with the connection to MLK. Ahora, nos encantaría presentarles a nuestros increíbles jóvenes y participantes de LAYC que han trabajado muy duro con sus presentaciones con la conexión de MLK.
To start us off, we have Isela Argueta introducing William Wirt Middle School's performances.
Hello, good morning, everyone. My name is Isela Greta Sanchez, and I go to William Wirt Middle School, and I'm in sixth grade. Today, I'd like to introduce people who will be presenting a spoken word.
Hey,
My name is Mariana. I go to William Wirt Middle School. I'm in sixth grade, and this is my poem. In life, there is peace in the world, like looking at the sky and rivers. We all have fun, even if we don't know that we are having fun in life. And always be confident and believe in yourself. You should be positive every day and complete your goals. We love to have fun and eat s'mores. We love to be positive, and so the meaning of this is be positive, like we can become and goals, and we all have all of that.
My name is Kelvin. I'm from William Wirt, and I'm in sixth grade, and this is my poem. I say that I'm tough and brave, but others say that I don't even wave. You think that you're tall, but some say you're really small. You see that everyone has their back, some are just using you. People may dislike you, but everyone you know loves you. Friendship is helping each other, giving advice, not judging one another.
Qué increíble! Shout out to Willie Ward Middle School. That's the school I gotta represent today. These students have a bright future ahead of them.
Next, I would love to introduce the LAYC Buck Lodge Middle School program presentation. Enjoy.
Hi, my name is Ashley Bravo, and I am a seventh grader at Buck Lodge Middle School. I am part of the LAYC MMYC AmeriCorps after school program, and we prepared a motivation video for you all. We want to highlight Charlene Mudd, who is our classmate, for creating two beautiful paintings that you will see in the video. Everyone enjoys it. Hola, mi nombre es Ashley Bravo y estoy en el grado 7 en la escuela de Buck Lodge Middle School. A continuación, les vamos a presentar un video que hicimos en el programa después de la escuela de LAYC MMYC AmeriCorps. Queremos agradecerle a nuestra compañera de clase Charlene Mack, que creó dos pinturas para presentarles hoy. Espero que lo disfruten.
The time is always right to do what is right. To me, this quote means that it is never too late to do the right thing.
It's always the right time to do what is right. I chose it because I like the words and I like the message.
The time is always right to do what is right. What it means to me is that we have to do the right thing all the time. We should wait to do the right thing. We should do it right away.
Forgiveness is not an occasional act. It does not mean ignoring what has been done or putting a false label on a bad action.
For me, it's about honoring someone who had the courage to stand up for what is right.
If you want to change the world, pick up your pen and write it. I choose the quote because it's very important, and it means for me that if you want to make your own things, you have to learn to do them in your own.
You can make it special if you want to make it special. Nobody else can make you think what you are thinking. You are the only one that can make anything happen.
Our lives begin to the end of the day. We become silent about things that matter. I chose this quote because I read it in my mind and then I thought about it a little. So then I said to myself that some people care about what's happening around them and not what they care about or what matters to them in their life.
I have a dream that my four little children will one day live in a nation where it will not be judged by the color of their skin, but by the content of their character. I chose this quote because it shows like how bad things were with racism in the past. So I made this art piece to show like we're all equal. It doesn't matter how different we are, we're still equal as a person. We all have the same blood. We still sleep at night, we still like breathe the same air. It's like we're all the same, we're all human, so we should all just be treated as equal no matter what. Darkness cannot drive out darkness, only light can do that. Hate cannot drive out hate, only love can do that. Like, if you're just like in a hole of darkness and you're like, you can't, if you try to push it out with darkness, it won't work because it will just show more darkness. But if you push it out with light, you can see like what is out there for you. Like, if you are just hating on everything, you can't really get out of that, like, just roll of hate. But if you show love, then you can actually see what's going on and break through that hatred that you are so, like, feeling of.
Wow. I am speechless for what our kids have been presenting today so far. Gracias a Buck Lodge Middle School por este maravilloso video. Next up, we would love to hear from Ijoma Kalu.
And a 10th grade student, enjoy our ASA performance.
That was great, Ijoma.
I love to see the effort that has been put into these presentations today, you guys. And with that, I would now love to introduce AmeriCorps member Lizbeth Villatoro.
Good morning, everyone. I hope you guys are enjoying our MLK Service Day event so far. Next up, I would love to introduce one of the most listened to rap artists in the DMV. I don't know if y'all have heard of him, but get excited because here is Buck Lodge Middle School Principal, Mr. Nance.
From every state and every city, we will be able to speed up that day when all of us, children, black men and white men, Jews and Gentiles, Protestants and Catholics, will be able to join hands and sing in the words of our Negro spiritual. Free at last, free at last, thank God.
Look at me.
We are free at last.
No one see.
I have a dream.
I want it, but lies.
bringing up the testicles and you don't know how I did it. I'm working butt lodge, butt lodge. Hey, I'm about to tell you where I work. Yo, my name is Mr. Nance and I hate to admit it. Bringing up the testicles and you don't know how I did it. I work at Buck Lodge where the kids are smart. They learn reading, writing, math, and art. I start my day at the front of the school where the buses pull up and my kids are cool. They step from the bus and they looking fresh. Some shirts tuckling, some look a mess. They grab their breakfast and head to class. Homework done and I hope they pass. Teacher turns on the morning show. Donors have to battle. G.I. Joe! I'm working for Lodge, but Lodge. I'm working for Lodge, but Lodge. Bringing up the touch message, you don't know how I did it. I'm working for Lodge, but Lodge. I'm working for Lodge, but don't get called to my office. Come to my office and make a fuss. I will suspend you off the bus. When you move through the hallway, please don't rush. No headphones, oh yeah, please don't cuss. Got a really good staff and that's a plus. Got an admin team that I can trust. And one last thing that is a must is that I'm this school's nucleus. I walk these halls till my feet get sore, so you can get this common core. Add two APs and I got one more. Teachers get their credit. Class is four. I got my degree from Eastern Shore. And if you don't like me, there's the door. I'm working for God, for God. I'm working for Lodge, for Lodge. Bringing up the test scores and you don't know how I did it. Education is freedom. Si se puede. And I'm out.
Can we give it up real quick for that incredible performance? Like, y'all, that was amazing. I don't know, any other principal rapping out here, you know? But thank you, Mr. Nash, for that incredible performance. As an AmeriCorps member who also serves at Buck Lodge, it's an honor working with you and serving at your school.
We need to get Principal Nance's record label right now, guys. Gracias por esa increíble actuación. Creo que con eso ya sabemos de dónde trabaja Principal Nance y a dónde mi compañero representa.
As you all know, COVID-19 has impacted the lives of our community in unprecedented ways. Dr. King encouraged all of us to protect, uplift, and serve our communities. As COVID-19 cases continue to rise, the best way we can protect one another is to get vaccinated. In our after-school program at Buck Lodge Middle School, our youth are hearing a lot of conversations at home about COVID-19 vaccinations. Las comadres always seems to be in the loop, so let's hear what the comadres have to say.
Chipotes, cállense. I'm making a very important call.
Buenas tardes, comadre. ¿Cómo están los chipotes?
Comadre, escuche que el fulanito le dio COVID.
¿Quién, comadre?
El niño de la comadre Rosa.
¿Y a dónde lo agarró, comadre?
Yo no sé, comadre. A mí no me gustan los chismes.
No lo voy a contar a nadie, pero no voy a salir de la casa de la comadre María.
Es que dicen que nadie de la familia está vacunado.
Es que nadie se quiere vacunarse, comadre.
Yo ya no sé en qué querer.
Si a usted todo le da miedo. Dicen que andan poniendo chips con las vacunas.
Es verdad, comadre. Yo miré un video en el Facebook que dice que en uno de esos países la gente se está transformando en zombies.
Ay, no, comadre. Hasta una serie salió eso. Se llama Walking Dead, creo.
Does this sound familiar?
Do you have a comadre at home?
Don't worry. We all do.
There is a lot of misinformation out there about the COVID-19 vaccine.
And it's not helping at all.
Did you know it is now safe for youth 5 years or older to get vaccinated?
We know it's tough to convince all the comadres in the world to get vaccinated, but with your help, we can make sure all comadres and all their fulanitos and fulanitas stay safe during this pandemic.
With a simple appointment, monthly everyone and your family can get the COVID-19 vaccine for free.
Together, we can end the COVID-19 pandemic.
Help your parents search for a vaccination clinic near you. If you have time for TikTok, you have time to help all comadres and their youth to get vaccinated.
And remember,
always wear your mask.
That's right, wear your mask. Can we get one more round of applause for that wonderful comadres video? See, Mr. Ike here and Miss Evelyn, they're icons now. They're comadres. All right, can we get another round of applause or at least Zoom claps for them, please?
No sé ustedes, pero yo creo que me voy a juntar con las comadres. What an awesome way to continue our celebration today. Muchas gracias a nuestros excelentes participantes y otra ronda de aplausos de Zoom, por favor.
Before we transition, we would like to thank all our students, parents, community members, partners, and LAYC MMYC staff for joining the first part of our MLK Day of Service event. Also, a deep thank you to our partners and funders who are joining us today. I also want to give one last shout out to our AmeriCorps members and my Ameri siblings for supporting and organizing this event. Now, we're going to transition to the second half of our day, the workshop portion. Please note that our students will need to participate in these workshops to receive their student learning service hours. While participating in these workshops and activities, remember Dr. King's words, injustice everywhere is a threat to justice everywhere. To me, this means that now is a great time to get active. Or as MLK said in another quote, the time is always right to do what's right. We hope these workshops impart some new ways of thinking about justice and getting involved.
Antes de continuar, nos gustaría dar una gracias a todos nuestros estudiantes, padres, miembros de la comunidad, socios y personal de LAYC MMYC por acompañarnos en nuestra primera parte de nuestro día de servicio de MLK. También un profundo agradecimiento a nuestros socios y financiadores que se unen con nosotros hoy. También dar un fuerte abrazo a nuestro equipo de AmeriCorps por apoyar y organizar este evento. Ahora vamos a pasar a la segunda parte del día, nuestra parte del taller. Por favor, tenga en cuenta que debería asistir a estos talleres para recibir sus horas de aprendizaje del servicio estudiantil. Con eso, mientras participa en los talleres y actividades, recuerden las palabras de Dr. Martin Luther King. La injusticia en cualquier parte es una amenaza a la justicia en todas partes. Para mí, eso significa que ahora es buen tiempo para ponerse activo. O como dijo MLK en otra cita, siempre es el momento adecuado para hacer lo correcto. Esperamos que estos talleres impacten nuevas formas de pensar sobre la justicia y de involucrarse.
We have multiple interactive and informative workshops about how we can better our community, including a kids' corner for our younger youth. In the chat is a directory of workshops to participate in. Each workshop is on a different Zoom link and listed in the directory. Please select your assigned workshop and click on the Zoom link to attend.